Now, the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with Doug Allen.
All right, pretty night going around the Susquehanna Valley. And as we look off to our west with the Super Doppler 8 radar network, at first glance, this might appear a little bit ominous here. All this rain coming up across New Orleans tonight, making its way up just east of the Mississippi River now and making its way into Indiana and Ohio. But a lot of this just kind of falls apart, loses its punch as it makes its way here, and that will be during the day tomorrow. We'll see clouds, though. It's 24 now. Winds are calm, and there's no wind chill because of that. The pressure's at 30.14, and it's slowly creeping up as high pressure gets a little bit closer. Overnight tonight, a starlit sky. We've got a few high, thin, wispy clouds out there, but not enough to help retard the temperature drop, which was pretty rapid right after sunset. Some teens around tonight, most of us right around 20 degrees. We'll see some high clouds filtering in during the morning, and more dense cloud cover will arrive. That's the remnants of the rain that I just showed you on Super Doppler 8. So by afternoon, we'll cloud over. There might even be a little sprinkle here or there. Best chance for that's going to be west of the river, and most of that will be wiped out as it tries to make its way east. But temperatures will climb back to the mid and upper 30s again, and still not too windy. Winds from the southwest at about 5 to 10 miles per hour. It's 25 now in Lancaster, Harrisburg 24, 17 in York. They drop really fast this evening right after sunset. Chambersburg's at 28, 22 in Williamsport, and a 20 stretching all the way down I-95 into Washington, D.C. and beyond. Now, the high today was 43, ever so briefly. Right after 3 o'clock, we spiked there, and then the temperatures really dropped back within a couple of hours. In fact, we lost a good 10 degrees within 2 hours' time there. Lowest 27 and no snow in the last 24 hours, and it looks like that trend is going to continue into next week, at least, maybe even beyond. Now, the river stages with minor changes are at a stage of 4.1 in Harrisburg as it stands. We cleared out nicely late today. We had a little bit of that milky kind of sky as we started the day off today. Those clouds moved off to the east, and now we're watching for the arrival of this next batch of clouds right in here. They'll start to filter in, very high, thin variety first overnight tonight, and then we'll cloud up during the day tomorrow. Look at here at the rain showers, how they're really just kind of falling apart by the time they get up to Indiana and Ohio. That's the effect that the high pressure is having, that and the fact that they can't just move east. They're being forced up around this high, which is going to be reluctant to give up any turf here. It's just going to hang on, really, as we head into the weekend, and it turns into a little bit of a heat pump. You know, we're not talking summertime levels here, but we're talking about some air that will be warmer than average for a change as we wrap up 2010. Here it is on the predictor. This high is just kind of lingering here. Here come the clouds for the day tomorrow. You know, they'll stick around into tomorrow evening. Then they break a little bit. On Friday, we get into this mild flow of air. We'll have some nice sunshine out there. That should bring temperatures pretty easily back into the mid-40s. And then as we celebrate New Year's Eve, right here, this is midnight, Friday night, a few clouds will be overhead. But temperatures, as a result of this light southwesterly breeze, should help to hold temperatures up. Mid-30s is what I'm thinking as we say hello to 2011. Then on Saturday, the clouds will definitely thicken up. This cold front's on our doorstep at that point. That's what's going to, you know, reduce the chances of a good game for some outdoor hockey in Pittsburgh, actually, on Saturday. Temperatures likely in the 50s with some rain coming down. That's not the best. May move it back to Sunday. I don't know. But we'll take a look at the temperatures here. This is for tomorrow. We're well into the 30s at that point. Watch down here. This warm air starts to get a foothold for just a change. As we go through the day on Friday, the blues, the cold air, beginning to push back to the north, receding a little bit, and our temperatures will climb into the 40s at that point. And just ahead of our cold front, we'll see numbers pop up. This, again, is New Year's Eve. Temperatures around 36 degrees. And then on Saturday, despite the lack of sunshine, our numbers will likely pop up, maybe nudging into the low 50s. On the other side of that front, it gets chilly again, but not really unseasonably so. So tomorrow, 38, mid-40s for Friday. Popped it up to 52 degrees for Saturday with clouds and then showers arriving. And then for Sunday, we'll have the showers wrapping up. Gets a little breezy for Monday, but we do clear out. And then for Tuesday, 38, and temperatures start to ramp it up ever so slowly again as we head for next Wednesday. So taking a look ahead, I think a New Year's Eve that's going to be pretty nice, Ron. I mean, a few clouds out there. It'll be dark. You'll hardly notice that. And wind should be relatively light. Temperatures in the mid-30s. I think those are pretty good ingredients for a good night to be out.
Yeah, with so many events we have going on around the Susquehanna Valley, no doubt we're going to have a tremendous turnout for our events.
Weather's always important, you know, at midnight. It's not often that we have to worry about a midnight, you know, okay to be outside, but that's the one night of the year.
It's a good night for families, it sounds like.
Yeah, sure is.
Thank you, Doug.